this is Callie, the Vintagely Inspired Seamstress, and I'm here again to talk to you about another one of my favorite pattern making books. This particular book is called Pattern Making, A Clear and Easy Guide by Norma R. Hollen. I think this book was copyrighted in 1973. I'm going to double check. 1975, originated in 1961, and my edition, 1975. I mean, it is a great, simple, easy to read, easy to understand, straightforward book. And let me go over a little bit of the preface for you, which is pretty short. Each revision of this textbook has been for the purpose of 1, expanding subject matter areas that seem to be limited in scope, and 2, adding new units that have been excluded because they represented garment features that were not currently in style. Now see me, I want to see those old styles. So for me, if I do love this book, if I run across the other editions, if I can get to 61 all the way through, I will buy them because I want to have them on my shelves. The revision has also offered an opportunity for the author to add illustrations, simplify techniques, and clarify directions to widen the fullness, usefulness of the text. This revision represents a new unit on pants and culottes. Culottes are so cool. The general information section has been reorganized somewhat for improved sequence of items. The information that was used for the basis for revised materials has come from a continual process of experimentation with pattern procedures used in flat pattern classes and from research studies with graduate students and from helpful suggestions made by fellow teachers. So this book is just telling you that this is a newer edition from the original 1961 edition, and that they've added some new information on pants and culottes, and they've revised a little bit more some of the information here just so that it's easier to follow along. And I find that this book is very, very useful, very easy to follow along. Regarding some of the little extras that these vintage sewing books offer you, I'd have to dig mine out, but this particular book, if you see, it comes with an appendix. And this appendix, Appendix B, it gave you a half scale sloper, a fourth scale sloper, a full scale French curve, a half scale French curve, and a fourth French curve. So back here, well, I've already cut out because I do use my books. I use my books. I write in them. I highlight. I think books are to be used, not just looked at. So I've already cut mine out, and I use them in flat pattern making. And I just appreciate that. Also, well, I hadn't seen in any of the other books. I don't think I've even seen a YouTube video on this, and maybe I'll do that. When it talks about supplies and equipment, it talks about how to make a little compass. I'm not going to show you that, but I like this section. It says how to use a French curve. I had never seen in a textbook before, modern day or vintage, before I ran across this particular book, where it gives you information on how you are to actually go about using a French curve. So I like that. It also talks about how to use a ruler. Now, we all know how to use a ruler, most of us, but this book is specifically talking about the usually it's in red, the clear ruler that most people use to figure out their bias lines or their grain lines. And it teaches you how to actually do that properly. So I thought that that was really nice in this book. There are a lot of black and white drawings and photographs throughout the book. This book, in my opinion, it has a really great section on darts. But it's a very simple, easy to follow book dedicated to flat pattern making itself. There's no draping involved, so if you're just looking for something basically for pattern making, I think that this is a great book, and it's not very expensive, but it is, it's talking about kimono sleeves. It's very nice. Again, there's a section on culottes. talks about fashion silhouettes of the day. So, just very useful book. So if you're going to get that, pattern making is a really great book.